Tom.
Well, I appreciate Heather's nomination and her confidence in my ability to steer the ship. I'm completely content with Nelly coming back for another year. I mean, this has been last year was probably the craziest year. Well, was definitely the craziest year I've spent as a school board member. And I think Nelly led us with some great skills and was a great chair, in my opinion. And I'd really like for her to have an opportunity of a normal year of being chair. And hopefully we can get back to normal some point this year and she can be in the boardroom and actually serve some time as a chair. So I would withdraw my name from consideration.
Director Sachs, oh, Heather, sorry, so used to
that's
that.
Okay. So my nomination for Tom is in no way no confidence for you as chair, Nelly. So it was just, you know, I looked at the sheet and to have a chair do it twice in a row seemed not common. So I thought, well, let's see who else, you know, and as Tom is vice chair, it made sense for him to move up if he was interested, but as we've heard, he's not. But, and I echo Tom's assessment that it's been an insane year to be chair and you've done a fabulous job. So thank you.
Thank you. Totally understandable. Never took it in that way. So just so you know. Okay. Anybody else? I accept the nomination from the members that had nominated my name to continue and also interested in continuing as we go through a crisis year. I think it's continuity is important to continue under the same type of rhythm or leadership, whatever we should call it. It was a difficult year, but I feel like it was a learning experience as well. And as we go into this new year, I feel like it's more of a connection of the previous year. And there's a lot of stuff that still needs to be done. And I have truly enjoyed working, even though it has been challenging through those difficulties with you, because all of you are the ones that actually make that leadership work. So thank you for your support. And I am very hopeful that this year we're gonna start seeing the light. So for me, this means like at the end of the year, it will be like, hey, you go for it. We can start all over again, a fresh and different way, and it will be all good. So just hope. Okay, so are we good there for now? In agreement? Okay, thank you. Okay, so for vice chair, we got Don. And Don, you also had a couple nominations there. Are you interested in continuing with vice chair or going to be in the vice chair? She said yes.
Sure, yes.
And is anybody else interested in being vice chair?
Looks like my favorite place to be. That's the best officer position as vice chair. If I could do it every year, if you guys would let me, I'd do it every year.
Don?
Well, I just wanted to say quickly that Nelly was the vice chair when I was chair, so I really appreciated working with her. So I'm looking forward to having a chance to do that in the reverse role. I can be the vice chair for her. So I thought we, you know, we worked well. We were able to, you know, have a good team. So I'm looking forward to it. Thank you.
Good.
Definitely agree. Heather?
I just have a quick request for Deb Bunkholt. I can't find the matrix that she sent us that has all of the, like, who nominated who and all of that jazz. It's not, as far as I can tell, it's not in the Google Drive. Could she send that to us by email?
Nelly resent it to me so I can forward it to
you. Okay, can someone just, because I don't have, it's the only thing I'm missing.
That would be good. That would be fine.
I was too.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Maya. Okay, the next one. So we're good here with Don, vice chair. And the next one we have is clerk. And then we have as interest, we have Heather. Any comments? Anybody else who was interested in this clerk position? I don't see anyone else here. I think we're good. Can I have a thumbs up just to make sure that I'm not assuming?
Okay.
I have a question or more of a comment for Clerk. In these times of the pandemic, when we're doing every vote by roll call, I've noticed other boards, they have the clerk do the roll call so that the chair can just concentrate on running the meeting and not have to worry about, you know, tallying up votes. So I don't know if that's something that we would like to do while we're continuing this pandemic. It might make your life a lot easier, Nelly, if you don't have to worry about, you know, moving the meeting and then trying to keep track of people's votes and just have the clerk do it. I mean, I think that's a board chair call, I would assume, but just an idea for you and the new clerk to consider.
Okay. We can definitely maybe talk about that during the week, and then, you know, I don't know if we would have to change something within our procedures here, school board elections. Possibly not. There's nothing in there, no. I don't think, that says that who gets to do the roll call. The call of votes.
Well, most districts I see the clerk does it. In 917, our Deb Bunkle counterpart does it. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, I just think it's, you know, the clerk doesn't have a lot to do except for sign things. Might give them or Heather a little more fun, where she's, you know, getting to call, take the role as well.
Yeah. Maybe we can talk about possibly alternating. I mean, I'm fine with it too, because in any case, I still have to, you know, stay on top of things to continue with the meeting. It's a possibility. We can certainly talk about that. I don't think it has to be tonight, correct?
However you guys want to plan it.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Tom. All right, so we got Heather going for clerk, and now we move on to treasurer, and we have Beth. If anybody else is interested, or if everyone is good with Beth, then can I have just thumbs up?
Okay, hey. Thank you.
Thank you, everyone. And then we have Deputy Clerk, which is Rod Sitkovich.
Yeah, he's good.
We usually have. Okay, district memberships, Intermediate District 917. We have Tom Bennett, who is serving a 3-year term from 7/1/20 to 6/30/23, and was approved on 6/22/20. So it makes common sense that he will continue because he's serving his current term. Then we move on to the next one is the MSH. Yes.
Sure. Sorry to interrupt, but thank you, Tom, for sending us that memo today about the various compensation packages others have had. I'm trying to recall when we had a situation where the board 917 wasn't paid a salary as much as they were paid per diem by the districts that they represented. Now, I also realized that not all of 917 board members are board members from other districts. Is that true? Do you know that?
At one point, they were all board members. I think they're currently all board members. When I first got on there a year ago, we had two 917 board members who were no longer members of their local boards, but their boards decided to keep them on 917. If that makes sense.
Yeah, right, because it is an appointed position. It's not an elected position. Thereby, you can have a member be on two boards, like you are, two boards at the same time, one elected and one appointed. And so I was trying to clarify that from previously, that with 287, when I was on 287, and we received just a stipend for attending the meetings, and then there were others from Richfield, Minnetonka, St. Louis Park, and other places that were no longer on their school boards, but were appointed by the school boards to be representatives of their district on the school board. So I just wanted to clarify that to be sure that, you know, as was the case before Tom took the thing, Dick Bergstrom going off of our board could have still been appointed to the two ways to the 917 board, but I guess he declined that. So that's when we went into a new 3-year term for this roundabout. Anyhow, just a bit of clarification on how all of that works. So it's
technically this position isn't appointed, it's elected. It's just elected by the board. So I was elected by this board to be on the 917 board. So it's a 3-year term. Right. So if I, like my 271 term ends next January, if I'm not on this board, I could still stay on that board.
Correct. For
the rest of my term. And then if I wanted to get reelected, I'd have to come to you guys and say, hey, do you want mm-hmm. I do this for another 3 years? And you guys could either do that or not do that.
Mm-hmm. And I guess that's the way all the intermediate boards do work. Is that right, Superintendent? Or do you know?
You're correct. That's my understanding.
Okay, thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Okay, so we're moving to the next one, which is the MSHSL. Membership, and we have Jim Sorum. I guess we will continue with Jim Sorum. Everyone okay with that, or was anybody interested? He's the only one, so I'm just gonna go for my thumb up.
I'm good with that. I'm just a curiosity, Jim, how often do they meet? Has it been controversial this last couple months with the whole pause and everything? I mean, what's it been like?
It really has, and they have a regional representative that's supposed to, like our school board region, and they elect somebody from our region who is on the big board that meets. Otherwise, they have the various coaches associations for each of the sports and other things like that. So if there ever comes up to be a big vote that they have all districts participate in a vote, then that's when I get called on to meet. And I represent both Jefferson and mm-hmm. Kennedy with a vote. So I have two votes really when we do meet. But that's not very often because the executive committees, coaches associations, and all of the regional groups meet, and then they do most of the decision making. But usually we should be getting from our regional representative. I don't know if who that is this time, if it's our MSBA representative, usually they would send out notes of what the high school league has been doing at their various monthly or otherwise meetings. But I haven't seen any of that. I'll pursue it and see what happens. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, and move to AMSD. And for Association of Metropolitan School District, we have, well, we used to have one person representing and then one alternate. And then last year, we decided to go with the one representative and two alternates because there were more than one board member who were interested in being alternates. But this year, we have three people interested in being alternates. And so we can only have two maximum because we can't have four board members in the meeting. Heather.
Was it, were Maya and Beth the alternates last year?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Then I'll just remove my name so you can continue to sit the same as you were before.
You can still attend meetings.
And I'd love to. We don't get the meeting information if we're not the representative. So if the representative could make sure that we get that meeting information, that would be really helpful because I haven't made one yet this year.
Mm-hmm. Right, correct. And the meetings are always posted. I mean, not the meetings, but all the material for the meetings are posted on the website mm-hmm. every week. And all the additional information. And that's why I was asking you a few days ago, weeks ago, if you were getting the emails from AMSD, all of you, because I was wondering if everybody gets those emails or just the people who are representative or alternates, but it seems like everybody gets those, correct?
My understanding is we get the like updates, but we don't get the meeting invite.
Right, not the invite, yeah, because we can have more than two or three people attending the meeting, otherwise there will be four of us in the meeting.
And Heather, I'm happy to tell you when it's coming.
Yeah. Okay. I just thought, I'm sorry. I thought Beth said we could attend. We just can't vote. Is that not true? Yeah.
Scott Kronquist told me that.
That everybody can attend? Is that what he said? Yeah. Everybody in the same. Okay. You just got to make sure you don't vote. Yeah. Okay. So you will get the invitation. Even if you don't get the invitation either, the meetings are posted also in their website. And the link is also posted in the website, in the schedule. There is a schedule in the website when the meetings are taking place, as well as the link. So if you're wondering if you don't happen to receive that invitation, then you can always go there. And depending on the agenda, if it's something that is of your interest, then you decide if you attend.
Mm-hmm. Is it consistent, like the first Friday of every month? Yes.
All right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very consistent.
Okay, thank you.
This particular meeting, the first one in January, is where they invite our legislators, and they usually have legislators present so we can share the legislative agenda that AMSD has. Mm-hmm. And so it's very interesting. It's very helpful, and I think there are some, critical things coming into play this year. So it'd be great for you to watch, even if you're not, one of the members. So go to the website and get that.
And that's this Friday.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
7:00.
So it's not a worry about a quorum or anything when we're doing it distance now, so it doesn't really make a difference. But if it starts to be in person, that's not a concern, Beth?
Not according to Scott, and it's open to others. You can even bring members of the community in. Yeah, that's what he told me. Wow. And so I think it's great if you're able to attend. I have learned so much. They've had some excellent speakers come in. I think it's just really opened my eyes. They sometimes have Morris Leatherman come in, and they do a survey that gives us some insight as board members on what's coming ahead. So I really recommend
it. I don't want to give it up.
I can still attend. I'm only an alternate if Nellie can't come, and that's happened once. So I definitely value it.
Yeah, yeah. And there's been times when the three of us have been in the room before the pandemic. So for me, it's actually the only committee that I can make to the meeting, because the rest of the time is during the working hours. So it's the only one that pretty much works out of the committees of the memberships. Okay, so I'm gonna remove your name, Heather, and knowing that you can attend the meetings, just not vote. Mm-hmm. Okay, all right. The next one is the MSBA Legislative Liaison. And I believe that Beth, you are the current representative, mm-hmm. correct?
Right, okay. Unless anybody else is interested. Mm-hmm. It's been really helpful to stay up to date, and Kim and Denise do a great job. Sometimes you can tune into the legislative sessions as they're occurring when there are votes that are really pertinent to us as school districts.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we're all good with Beth continuing, or everybody else was interested?
Great, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, then we have the MSBA Delegate Assembly. And for this one, this is MSBA, it's the organization that approves who the delegates will be. And this is through an application process. So we have come to the end of our term this year, Beth and I. And then I believe we have to apply again. And whoever wants to apply can do it. It will be MSBA decision, not our decision. Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, so the next one is the subcommittee memberships and chair appointments. And starting with the legislative committee. And we have four people interested in being part of the legislative committee of three. So we got Nelly, Heather, Maya, and Beth. Any comments on that? Heather?
I think this is another situation where I put my name on where you, it was already just the three of you, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm all for 2020 being a repeat of 2021 being a repeat of 2020. I think consistency is going to serve us well this year. Yes. So I just put my name down on stuff that I was interested in, but I have no desire to kick anyone off. So let's go ahead and remove my name and then the three of you can stay consistent again.
Okay.
Yeah, because I considered, like, you know, I'm interested in what Beth is doing as a legislative liaison, but at the same time, I also thought this year's been so crazy. I just told Deb just the same thing again.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That's kind of what I did. I just signed up for the same things.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And I know that, Heather, you are very involved in all legislative matters, so we truly appreciate your continuous feedback and recommendations, you know, even if you're not part of the committee. In any case, when we go to advocate at the Capitol, obviously everybody goes. And so it doesn't really make that huge of a difference. We just make recommendations to the board. And we would always continue to take feedback from the rest of the board and the decisions that we make. Okay, so we got Nelly, Maya, and Beth. Thank you. And then superintendent evaluation. We got Jim, who is the current chair, and Heather. Mm-hmm. Seems like we need one more person here.
It seems like I am on the least. I'm not on. I didn't sign up to be an officer, and I'm on the least committee. So if you need me to be on that, I will do that.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Are we okay with that? Should I add Maya then?
Mm-hmm.
There was also a nomination here for Beth and Heather. Heather is already there in the list.
Yeah. I've been on it for three years, and I just thought I'd give someone else an opportunity, and I enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm.
But I just thought someone else can do something too.
Okay. So we're going with Jim, Heather, and Maya. The policy committee for three as well. So we got here Tom, Jim, Heather, and Beth.
So I want to give Heather some time to be on it. And it's interesting. I was glad I wasn't on this year because it was an extra busy year for me. But whenever anybody wants to get off, I'm willing.
Okay, Tom?
Yeah, well, we're kind of in the policy committee, we're kind of in the middle of this, our goal this year of the safe supportive schools and aligning policies with that. So I think it's something we've already started. So my preference would be to keep the three people that we already have, at least for this next year, just so we can get through that process. And Heather's only been on there for a year, so I think I would hate to see her leave after just 1 year, especially when policy is one of her jams, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
Policy.
Okay. My other feedback too is this coming month, I believe it's gonna be the first month where our new policy procedure will kick in. So we'll be where the board sees the policies of meeting in advance prior to the vote. Am I correct on that, Tom?
Well, that's a pass first. So that policy hasn't passed the board yet. Once it passes, then the next time that'll be the procedure where we'll get to discuss the policy in a meeting. And then if there's no recommendations for changes, then it'll go into the consent agenda of the next meeting.
Okay. So I'll be curious too to see if that helps the rest of the board feel a little bit more involved in the policy making process. I don't ever want anyone to feel like they don't have a voice on policy, since that's one of the biggest things that we get to do here. So
sounds good.
Exactly. Okay, so we are in agreement that we remain with the same people with this committee. That will be Tom, Jim, and Heather. Community Engagement Committee. We got Dawn and Maya. Now this one is three.
I've not done that one, and I'm willing to do that since you need three people.
We're all good with that? Beth taking that place. Okay, good. Thank you. So it would be Dawn, Maya, and Beth. The Board Student Advisory Council. We also need three for this one. And we got Beth. And Beth, you're the current chair, correct?
Correct.
And then we have Maya. And then there's also a nomination for Heather to be part of this committee.
Yeah, and I would come back on that committee too. The only reason I didn't put my name on there is because those 5:30 meetings tend to be challenging to get to, but I love meeting with the students. That's not at all. I mean, that's super fun. It's just the timing of it, trying to get three children and a husband figured out before I have to be on screen or at the meeting is challenging, but it's I can make it work.
Tom?
Yeah, you know, that committee is so much fun. And I really think that Maya and Heather should stay on for another year because, you know, and hopefully we get back to some normalcy and they can actually participate in the meetings in the library and have all that nice conversation, which isn't the same when it's on Zoom. So I think they should both stay on there for at least another year.
Yeah, I agree. Okay, so we're good with
you. Oh, Jim has a question.
Oh, Jim, sorry.
So it is Zoom now, and you still meet with every other month with the middle school and the high school? Or how do you structure the meetings now on Zoom?
Well, currently, we're meeting once a month, and it's usually the night that the representatives are part of our meeting. That's been the way we've done it in the past. And then I believe it's three times that we do it with the middle school a year. And we met once with them. Or am I thinking of last year? No, we have. So we look forward to hopefully opening that up.
Sure.
Yeah, before the pandemic, those high schoolers are meeting like every Monday. I mean, it was pretty crazy. They're really ambitious.
Yeah. Yeah.
And then you have virtual pizza that you show that they should have too.
With our virtual appetites.
That was a big drawing card. That was always a big drawing card for those middle schoolers. Yeah. Hey, we have pizza.
Yeah.
They really enjoyed it. Okay, so we got Beth, Maya, and Heather staying in that committee. Let's move to the committees required by law, the board representative, the Pathways Advisory Committee. We can only have one person, and we have two people interested, Dawn and Heather. And I believe Dawn is the current representative. Heather?
Here's another situation. I'll just take myself off. Dawn can continue.
All right, everybody good with that? Dawn?
I just wanted to say thank you because we've had two whole meetings, so it would be nice to be able to continue and actually be on it when hopefully things are a little more normal. So thank you, Heather.
Thank you. The ECFE Parent Advisory Committee, we need one person and there's a space there. Who would be interested? Heather.
Good. So that's me currently. I would happily continue, but this is a place where if anybody else wanted to try it out, we've had one so far this year. There's another one scheduled later this month, I believe. It's either January or February. And then another one, I think, in May. So virtual meetings. But so I'll be happy to continue, but also am fine opening it up to someone else if they're interested.
Tom?
Yeah, I'm for Heather keeping that. I mean, I love that committee. You know, that's where Heather and I both got our start. So it's kind of like going home. So, but I've already been on that committee. I think I did it for 2 years already. So I think we should keep Heather there unless someone else really, really wants it.
Anyone?
Yeah, I was just gonna say that I thought that I would I had put that as an interest last time, but since I thought we were going to kind of try to keep our same position, so Heather, just let me know if you want me to do that.
Well, you can always go to the meetings.
Mm-hmm.
If you wanted to check them out.
Yeah.
If those of you that remember Dick Bergstrom, he used to go to every committee meeting, whether he was on it or not.
That sounds so much like him. I love it.
I asked about that, and I thought they said that we couldn't do that. So.
Well, I think the problem was getting with the PTSA council, because there were multiple board members showing up, and they didn't want to get into an issue of a quorum of four people coming. So I think that was the only one that ran into problems. But the ECFE one, it's usually the board rep and Dick would be the ones that would show up.
Okay.
Dick's up the bar too high.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you're planning on going, maybe let the representative know.
Okay.
So that we're sure that four of us don't show up at the same meeting.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're good with Heather, correct? That's what we said.
Heather, are you good with Heather?
Yeah, I am. And I think there's a good point. They're barely off the ground this year, so it'll be good to be a part of it for a little bit longer. Yeah.
Correct. Okay. The next one, Community Education Advisory Council. We have to have one representative. We got two people interested, Jim and Beth.
I'm just interested in being on one of these advisory committees for the experience. I haven't had that experience yet. So just trying to broaden my horizons.
And I would just as soon stay on it. It's new, we have a new director and there are some new members on it. And so I have been able to add a little bit of continuity to it.
Okay.
But here again, it's another advisory community education. We learn about all of the different programs and we usually have people come and only meets every other month or something like that. Sometimes in the morning, I guess we're pretty much stabilized to be in the morning rather than we tried late afternoon and evening and it didn't meet everybody's schedules. So we went back to early morning, 8 o'clock, and then we would just hear from the various departments and talk about budgets and all those types of things too. But once again, the invitation is open to anybody who wants to attend.
Okay. Beth?
I'll take my name out. I think Jim has a good point about, you know, there's new people and a new director, and he does have that background, that historian to help out. So that's great.
Yeah, very valuable.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. Special Education Community Advisory Committee. We can only have one, and we have Maya as the person interested. Mm-hmm.
That's fine.
Everybody good with that? Perfect. The next one, the Community Collaborative Council, one representative, and we have Jim.
And I have to ask, is that still a functioning group, or has they pretty much gone to the District Diversity Advisory Committee? You know, Superintendent or Deb, I haven't been to a meeting with CCC, and talking with Dina today, it seems that most of these issues, concerns, and everything else is taken up with the District Diversity Advisory Committee, which there is plenty of participants. you know, from the district. So if there is a committee, community collaborative council, and I think Dina was still the main person, I'll do it. But if there isn't any, then.
Well, this one is the one that's required by law. So,
Chair, you're right. It is required by law for the Achievement Integration Act.
So there has to be a committee.
Okay, because I don't think we met last year. But anyhow, I'm sure it has a lot to do with the EEO budgets and things like that, as well as the other group that meets. Okay.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
I'll be more than happy to participate in that group.
Okay, Don?
I just want to say I have been on both of them, and what I remember is there, Jim is right, there is a lot of overlap in membership, mm-hmm. but I think the community collaborative had a broader membership to other community members in addition to the people that were on the diversity committee, but it did not meet very often, even pre-COVID. I would assume that, you know, it could still meet at this, you know, in the next coming year or so.
Seems like this would be an important year for it to meet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it certainly is. It's required. Okay, so
Don is
right. Okay, thank you, Deb. All right, so we're going with Jim for that one, correct?
Yeah.
We're all good in that. Good. The next one is the advisory to board committees, board representative, the community financial advisory, CFAC. It sets two representatives, and we have Don. Looks like we need another one. Don, go ahead.
Typically, it's also been the treasurer, I think, that attends those. So I don't know if our treasurer will be interested in that, but I think that's really? Who was on them before.
Okay.
When was the last time they even met?
It's been a while.
Yeah, it's at the discretion usually of Rod and maybe between Rod and the superintendent whenever we have like referendums or whenever we need some real community input from a lot of financial type people. There's been bankers and other accountants and other economists and so forth that have been on there when called upon just to discuss the some financial aspect of the district. And it's been a good functioning committee when they meet. Just to be able to say, you know, that we've run some of these recommendations and thoughts past the Community Financial Advisory Committee, and this is what they say. So it is good. And I think, Beth, you were on it last year, but I don't think they met last year either.
No, they did not.
Yeah.
I was on it when I was treasurer, and that was like my year two, and we met like three or four times. And
yeah,
the box lunch and everything, I thought it was a very... very good committee to be on. You got to learn a lot about the finances and stuff. So it was very helpful.
Heather?
I actually asked this question as part of learning about the audit process for the first time. And it was September of 2017 was the last time that group met.
Wow.
So,
Deb has indicated that it's called as needed.
Right.
Chair, Jim's correct. It's called as needed. It's called by the finance director, Rod, and he usually calls it when we're considering a referendum, sale of bonds, because he asks for their advice. Mm-hmm. And then he takes that advice to the board and he says he's consulted with community experts and this is their advice. Go out for referendum this year, they'll support it. Go out for bond sale right now, support it. That kind of advice.
Okay.
So I have a question. When we're doing like right sizing the budget, would it be worth taking some ideas to them to get opinions from them about right sizing the budget?
Yes, we've done that in the past.
Okay.
Okay. Heather.
I just like the idea too, because I remember when I first learned about the group, when I was a parent and involved in PTA, it was that extra layer of accountability, right? Because there were all these folks that saw the district's finances. And so it was just another level of that accountability for the public and such too.
And we intentionally went out and recruited the city finance director, the finance director from Normandy Community College. We got bankers, insurance leaders, and also an economist to be on the committee. So we went with financial experts because when we went to the community, we could tell them we got financial advice from community members.
Very good. Okay, so we have Don and Ben. We're good?
Yeah.
Okay, the next one, operational committees, board representative. We have the calendar committee, one representative, and we have Heather. Heather, you like the calendar.
I love doing the calendar committee. It's a crazy puzzle. We got 2 years done in a row now, so I don't know if we'll meet this year. Well, we might probably did, you know, I think we're going to try to be 2 years in advance now from this point forward. So
it'll make it easy for anybody who goes on it the next time, though.
I would be happy if Heather kept that forever.
I love that committee. I lived on that committee, and then Don stole it from me. Then I finally stole it back, and then Heather came and stole it from me. So I don't know if I'll ever get it back.
Oh, it's a good committee to be on, but I just think that Heather just, you know, she just loves it, and she likes the puzzle of it. So she's perfect for that committee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. And wasn't Maureen the person who was also in that committee for many
years? Oh, yeah, I stole it from Maureen.
There you go. It's about organization, you know, you got that mind for that. Perfect. Okay, so we'll go with Heather. Insurance committee. Got Jim and Beth interested, and we can only have one person.
You know, I can go off of it. I've been on it for 3 years. So I don't mind giving it up.
And I can go off of it too.
You know, Maureen and I were together on it. And I thought that Jim and I were together.
Yeah, and we don't really input that much because it's the insurance agents and then it's the union representatives that do most of the talking. So we're just kind of... background people or whatever it is, because certain questions come up about, well, how do you think the board is going to accept this? So that was basically what role we did, if I remember.
Mm-hmm. Don?
I believe that we have had two people in the past, because I also was on it with a second person. So I'm not sure if that is a change on our survey or not, but we have usually had two board members at it. Also, I would say that it's another really good one for people to learn about some of the finances, and especially about a district that is self-insured. There's a lot of great information in it. So it's a really good one to really understand how a lot of things operate in the district.
Mm-hmm. Can we possibly have an alternate so you both can be in it?
Sure.
Well, I mean, they're non-voting members. You could have two people on there. It's not like they're voting on anything.
They meet, monthly on Wednesday morning, 7:30 to 9:30. So it's during the day. So that's easy enough for some people, like for my schedule it is. But and it's sometimes not always attended totally by the union reps that are there too. So, I mean, depending on their schedules, because some of them are in school teaching or whatever it is, but the two or three insurance reps really know their stuff and really give us good information on it. And Mary and Rod are both in on it from the district too. So it is helpful to see what the picture is all about. So if somebody has a real burning desire to work with numbers and to get in there and do that stuff early in the morning. You know, raise your hand.
Anybody
have a question? I'm already on the insurance committee in 917, so I don't need another one. But I was wondering, are they still meeting monthly? I know when it was labor management, they were meeting every month. Yeah. Are they still doing that as an insurance committee? Because I wouldn't think they'd have to meet that often.
Well, and that's what it has been. And maybe they say next month, because for a while the rates were changing, you know, and we were getting into all kinds of stuff pre-COVID, you know, that we were really dealing with some of the stuff. Mm-hmm. We haven't met for a while. Mm-mm. Yes, I don't know if they met last month or not. I don't think so.
No, they did not.
Mm-mm. Yeah, so if Jim and Beth want to do it, that should be fine. Unless Heather and Maya want to learn about self-insurance and stop loss and bids, and it's a fascinating world.
I learned a lot.
Jimmy, Donnie was talking about this.
John?
Well, I just wanted to say, Deb, we saw a message that Deb was going to check with Mary Barrows about one or two. So can we just leave it that Jim is doing it, and if they can have two, Beth can join? And can we leave it that way so we can just be done with it for tonight and just leave it that way?
Okay. Right. With Beth and Jim.
Okay. Is that okay with you guys?
Sure.
That's fine.
Perfect. Thank you, Don. Okay, the next one, the District Diversity Advisory Committee, we have Nelly and Maya as an alternate. This one, we actually have, I believe it was just one meeting in the year.
Really?
It was one or two.
There's one tomorrow, the DDAC with Dina.
That's an invitation that we got, correct? Yeah.
Yeah.
You only have one or two, you said, Nelly?
Say that again.
You've only had one or two?
Yeah, we only had like one or two last year.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
Yeah, they were not, well, that I recall, not too many. But I know that Jim was also in that committee.
Yeah, I
remember we met once in person. I do remember meeting once, a big meeting, a lot of people there. That was before COVID. And then I believe we met once virtually, if I'm correct.
And that was the curious part for me, because with the CCC and then the DDAC, I guess maybe I got them confused and went to one or the other. But in any event, it's a big group, and so there's a lot of stuff to discuss.
I think so, Jim, because I think you were in that committee before I was last year, and then you ended up in the other one, the CCC, but then you came to the one where I wasn't. And it's okay.
Yeah.
I was wishing that I had been able to attend, but now I don't feel as bad since I know that you didn't really have, I didn't miss a lot at them.
Well, because of COVID, there was a big, you know, chunk of time where there was no meeting, so. You know, I hope I'm remembering okay, because I'm sure Dina is watching. So, okay.
So as an alternate, now that we're discussing this, that anybody can go to any, did Dick go to this too before, Tom? Did Dick go to this one too? I mean, did every, so I can attend it too?
I think we have always tried to be mindful of the person who is the representative and allow that person to attend, and the alternate would attend if that person is not able to attend that certain meeting.
Okay.
We have always been really careful about that. I don't really want to give the idea that now we can go to all the meetings of all the committees, because all of a sudden, we're just going to have a lot of board members in the same meeting. And I don't know how that will also, what it would be like for the people who are part of that committee too, who are not board members. So I don't, we got to be cautious about that, as well as maybe running into having all of a sudden four board members sitting in a meeting, in a committee, because we all want to attend all the meetings of all the committees. So I can understand the desire to be there, but we gotta be also mindful of who is the person represented, because that's also a reason, there's also a reason why we have a representative.
Right, and it may be confusing to people as to who is the representative. So. Okay, I understand that. But I don't imagine the whole board will be going and sitting in on the insurance committee meetings.
But... the calendar, right?
We'll be arguing over it.
Okay, so but for this one, we have Nelly and Maya, you as an alternate. So obviously, you know, you're the alternate. You can go to them all the meetings. That's not an issue. So are we all good with the two of us, or was anybody else interested in being in this District Diversity Advisory Committee this year?
You know, Nelly, I think the times that we've been in there, they on this committee, they have actually, Dina and others have actually recruited our suggestions and information sharing with it. You know, we've been treated like a regular member of the group rather than more in the advisory capacity or just sitting watching, making sure that if they did have any questions from a board perspective, we could maybe offer something. But this one was pretty interactive with the whole group. And so we'll have to double check with Dina on how she wants the board maybe to play this game.
That's a good, that's a good comment. We can always check and see, you know, what kind of dynamic will be taking place. Okay, but we need to move on here. So is anybody else interested? Question on being representative or alternate. Otherwise, I think we're good. Okay, so we'll go with Nelly and Maya. And I think Deb just posted something in the chat.
Yeah, I think that was for the insurance committee.
Insurance, yeah, two board members no longer meet every month. Okay, so two board members, then we'll go as we said we would do with the insurance, which was Beth and Jim, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Is that correct. What, yeah. Okay, perfect. Okay, let's move on to the other organizations, board representatives, the PTSA Council, and one representative and one alternate. We have Jim, Heather, and Maya. Heather?
You can go ahead and remove me as alternate there as well. I'm there on behalf of PTA. At least I will be until I'm not president of PTA anymore in June. And then next year, I don't know what that'll look like, but I'm fine with
okay.
taking my name off there.
If you're there anyway, though, then would you want to stay on there? I was just going to say, because I ended up, you ended up taking your name off of a couple of things. So if you wanted me to take my name off of this one, I'd be okay.
No, it's all right.
Because even though, Heather, you're there as the PTA president, your board hat doesn't come off. You're still a board member. So you're still representing the board when you're there.
Yeah.
I try really hard not to. I mean, I only talk about state level stuff.
Yeah.
Well.
But it doesn't mean that
you're still a board member, though.
Yeah, everyone else still sees you as a board member.
The board hat doesn't come off. It's not like you can decide, nope, I'm not a board member. You're still a board member, so you're still the alternate if you're there.
Well, you're obviously there to represent the board.
Yeah.
That's the
whether you want to or not.
That's unfair, you guys. That's not
really.
It is reality. Sorry.
Well, then do I need to be alternate then if I'm there?
I would think, because if you were going to be there, you're still a board member. So if four members came, you couldn't be like, oh, well, it's not a quorum because I'm not representing the board. No, it would still be a quorum. Yeah. So I think if you're going to be there, it should be listed as an alternate. And if the member can't make it, then you're going to have to fill both roles.
Yeah.
I kind of disagree. I think Heather has that role as the PTA president. So naturally, information she shares is from other PTAs, and it's pretty much in that light that she speaks. And presents information that other districts are doing or shares different things or programs or whatever it is. Very, very seldom does she speak on behalf of the board. Well, very seldom do I speak on behalf of the
board. Board members don't either. Well,
but at the same time, having it be three isn't necessarily thought of that way.
Is this one of those things that I only go if Jim can go?
Yeah, and that's once a month on Wednesdays, 11:30 to 1 o'clock. Usually the first Wednesday of the month. So that would work out all right if you wanted to be the alternate when I couldn't make it, yeah.
Well, the only problem with that is that time only works with advance notice for me because I take substitute teaching jobs.
Hmm. Oh, yeah.
So maybe I shouldn't be on there as an alternate.
Okay, so we have Jim for sure.
And then why don't I take the alternate then? And then there won't be this conflict of interest stuff that you guys are discussing.
Did you say you will? You will, right? Is that what you said, Heather?
Yeah.
Sorry. Okay.
Because then if Jim couldn't make it, she's already there. So then the problem,
Correct. Okay. Oh. So we go with Jim and Maya Heather as an alternate.
But if Heather can't make it, then I'm going to have to know what she wants to talk about.
I'll give you my PTA notes.
Yeah, right. Oh, dear.
Okay. Okay,
we got 20 minutes left here. So let's move on to the next one. The Bloomington United for Youth, one representative, and we have Maya as interested in this organization. Was anybody else? Everybody good with that?
Good.
Yes. Okay. Maya. The Education Foundation of Bloomington. I got Dawn and Beth.
Mm-hmm. I just am interested in being on that at some point because I appreciate what they do so much. Mm-hmm. So, Dawn, have you been on it?
Just this last year, or just since last January. So
okay.
Yeah, I think Maureen was on it forever, wasn't she?
Maureen,
yeah, I think so.
She used to be the person.
We have actually had some virtual meetings though, so unlike some of the other things that haven't been able to meet, they have been able to meet. So,
I saw her name. She's on the board. Not Maureen's on the board of the Education Foundation, right?
Yeah.
Yes, she is.
Mm-hmm. So, I'll take my name off so that Dawn can have more experience on that.
Okay, that would be Dawn. Good. And the next one we have is the BPS Advocacy Council. And the way this one works is always the board chair and chair of the board community. Yeah, it's the chair of the community engagement committee and the legislative committee. Because how it works. Yeah. Okay, so that one's sitting there. And then we got the next one is the negotiations for next contract 21-23. For clerks, I got three board members here who are interested. And then I have some other spaces that are not filled yet. So let's start with clerks.
I could go down to the custodial.
Custodial. Okay.
Nellie.
That's a fun one.
Yes, Heather.
Mm-hmm. Are there any negotiation groups that you guys would consider like entry level negotiation groups for those of us that are brand new to board negotiating?
Teacher is probably the easiest one. So you should start with that.
I have to tell you, I'm super nervous about this part of my role, honestly. And so, I want to make sure I do it right.
Yeah.
You have to remember that you're really just there in the role to observe. And when you meet with your, the negotiator is the only one that is supposed to be speaking in negotiations. So it's more about your role when you meet with your team. in caucus, so not about in the actual negotiations. So, well, you know, you're the board's voice in the caucus, just around parameters, that kind of stuff. But don't think that you have to speak during negotiations, because that is the negotiator's role. There's only one voice in there.
Right. And it comes down to time as well. You know, how much time would you have to be part of some of those meetings? You know, because for example, in my case, due to my teaching role, I cannot be constantly meetings for negotiations. So I have had experience only with custodial, transportation, food service, possibly with nurses once, but it kind of depends of time too, because some groups will take longer than others. So there's more meetings too, and sometimes the time of the day for those meetings as well. Jim, you were gonna say something. You have a lot of experience on all those negotiations.
And clerks is not a difficult one. That would probably be a good one. So I'll take my name off. Otherwise, Heather, I was going to say the nurses and health services might be a good one too. But Beth, were you going to go to custodial?
Yeah, I'll go to custodial.
And okay. And you'll be doing that while you're still working with the paraprofessionals, right?
Right. That one is quite elongated.
Since the paraprofessionals haven't settled yet, I don't know if they're going to be doing them together. So I don't know if it'd make more sense, Beth, to keep you on that, or if it's better to change it.
You can sign me up for the nurse one, probably. I mean, are we each on one no matter what? Is that right?
Right.
You know, maybe it would be good for me to do the paraprofessionals. I'm looking for a different experience too.
Okay, hold on. Just to make sure, for clerks, we're gonna stay with Heather, correct? That's what we said.
Yeah, sure.
Heather, yeah, that's a good one. I'll have to request either, well, Beth wants to be in the custodial. The one that's open there now is nurses, so I'll have to request that one once again, because there are certain negotiation groups where I don't think I should probably be in, because
the nurses meet after school, at least they used to, so that probably work for you. Correct. Now whereas the custodial transportation, they meet at 11:30, so you can make those anyway.
And I remember that being in that one once, and that was easy for me to do, you know, considering time. So you're right, this is an afternoon. So if you're okay with that, I will like to claim the nurses.
I'm just thinking over some things. Mary would probably appreciate me having the history of having gone through the most current negotiations with paraprofessionals to go into this next one. So maybe I should just stay on the paraprofessionals and not be on another one.
Good, then I'll take custodial transportation.
Okay. Custodial, Jim.
So you're going to end up putting me on the teachers. That's going to be.
And then we got, hold on. Then we got, then we have food service. We have Don. You go with that one, Don. And then we
I just picked food service because I've already done teachers, I've already done paras, I've already done principals, and I've already done transportation. So I tried to pick one I haven't had.
Yeah. Well, I see that Tom is interested in principals too. So Tom,
I just picked principals because I haven't done that one yet. But yeah, I don't know if putting Maya on teachers, being that she's a substitute in the district, it's a good idea.
So, I was thinking of that. Maybe I should go on the teacher one for my and give them my business perspective of what is to be done. So I'll go teachers. I haven't been on that one for
Jim?
Longer. Yeah, I'll go teachers.
So then am I going to custodial transportation?
Yes. You're trading with Jim.
Yep. So, custodial transportation is fun. It's like two different units in one. So you get to see a whole different aspect of the district that you don't necessarily see as a teacher and para. You get to see the behind the scenes stuff and all the different things.
I'm the transportation advocacy.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah. I'm fine with doing that. Thank you. Thank you, Jim.
Great.
Okay, just want to make sure we got the right ones here. Now we got principals, Tom, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so just to make sure we're right here, clerks, Heather, custodial transportation, Maya, food services, Don, nurses, health service, Nelly, paraprofessionals, Beth, principals, Tom, and teachers, Jim. Okay, good. I think we're at the end of that list. So the next item there in that agenda is the current policies pertaining directly to school board members. And so everybody has received, the information. So please remember to review the information pertaining each one of those policies, the school board elections, the school board student representatives, the school board meetings, the school board policies, regulations, out of state travel by school board members. And so make sure that you skip
a whole bunch of stuff.
Did I skip something?
You skipped E, F, and G.
Oh my gosh, it's because we're running out of time. Okay, so those, please take a look at them before our meeting next week. And now let's go into the school board compensation discussion.
So I just wanted to say, I sent you guys all the salaries for member districts in 917, just so you can see a comparison. And as you can see, even though we haven't adjusted our salary in 15 years, we're still at the top of all of our member districts. Yeah. So I'm not really in favor of raising our salary. But one thing I noticed is with all those districts is they give extra money to the chair. And after, being a vice chair and seeing how much work a chair does, and it's more meetings, it's more phone calls, it's more emails, it's, protests at their house. There's a lot of work to be a chair. So I would be in favor of giving an extra salary stipend for the chair of an extra $50 a month. So we're talking an extra $600 a year or something. So for the chair to make 7,800 and other board members make 72. I don't know if anyone else has an opinion on that.
Heather.
So I was going to propose the same thing because I've seen it in many other school districts where the chair is paid more. I was thinking somewhere between 50 and 100 a month would be appropriate. And then the other thing I wanted to mention is, yes, Bloomington hasn't gotten an increase in their stipends since 2005. Yes, we are one of the higher paid, but we are also one of the largest school districts as well. So when you look at, the list, the larger school districts still have the higher salary. So I'm not advocating for increasing it now, but I do think, a 15-year flat rate maybe needs to be considered within the next year or two. But I definitely think the chair part should be evaluated this time around.
Dawn?
Since we have 6 minutes to get through the rest of this agenda, I would suggest that we go with what Director Bennett said, unless anybody else disagrees. And there's no vote tonight anyway, so we can just for now say, yes, we're going to go with that. And move on.
We'll that discussion when we come on our formal meeting next week. Mm-hmm. Looks like everybody's good with that. Okay, mm-hmm. Perfect. The school board budget expenditure. We haven't gone over our, many of us haven't even gotten closer to using the budget that we're allowed to use. So sure, most of it will be virtual once again this year. So does it seem like we're good and continuing where we're at right now with the type of budget that's assigned for us?
I think so.
We don't travel anywhere. We're not going to go anywhere far. So seems like we're good, correct?
And sometimes when we've gotten into a situation, we tap into, you know, 50, 100 bucks from every member to help pay for a particular issue or something like that. Mm-hmm. So I voted even for keeping it the same.
Our MSBA conference is also free this year, so that made a difference as well. Okay, and the last one is the attorney retainer, and you have had received information about this. I don't know if there's any comments of what is proposed.
Yes.
Any objections, or we're good with that?
It's good.
Everybody good? Okay, I don't know where Director Bennett went, but maybe he disconnected or something.
I think he froze and then disconnected.
And then disconnect. Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. Good. Okay. So this is it. And unless you have anything else, we have 5 minutes before we leave to get ready for our special meeting. Well, all right. Well, thanks everyone. Once again, it's fun to be here with you all. So thank you. And I'll see you in a few minutes.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Thanks. Bye. Thank you.